Breaking, 52 people shot, 11 dead so far, waiting on police and president to address the nation. The last 36 hours have been among the bloodiest on record, leaving 13 dead and an additional 52 victims were wounded in the brutal ambush, 11 of which have died. As people in this area are trying to come to grips with the sudden attack, President Donald Trump will soon be addressing it, as he's expected to make an announcement about the bloodbath that has never been said before. While most people were looking forward to the weekend, Chicago thugs were preparing for a bloodbath, knowing that nobody would stop them at their killing game that began on Sunday, October 22nd, and continued through Friday, October 27th. Officials in Chicago have overlooked the problems in their city for too long, and it's been at the cost of countless lives. As Barack Obama's former hometown, he didn't seem to want to address it either, and the rising murder rate is also a big part of his legacy, having made excuses for criminals and empowered Black Lives Matter. Now that there is a real leader in charge, President Donald Trump isn't letting murderous thugs get away with this killing spree at a rate of one fatality every hour and 45 minutes in the Windy City, according to stats provided by HeyJackass.com. The respect for human life is completely absent in the tight gun-controlled city on both ends of the spectrum. Thugs pick their victims at random without concern for age, as was seen this weekend with the unprecedented violence. This lack of respect extends to local government, which has done nothing to stop and remove citizens' right to defend themselves against it. Chicago has become more of a war zone than a place to call home, where it's not even safe to go outside without risking your life. Now Trump has come out announcing that Chicago cops need to be able to do their job, which would stop this crime spree immediately. President Donald Trump's claim that a mystery police officer has a quick fix for Chicago's violent crime problems continued to evolve Wednesday night, as the president claimed the unnamed cop told him if they let us do our job we could stop it immediately, CBS reports. By being very much tougher than they are right now. They're right now not tough, Trump said in an August 2016 interview with Bill O'Reilly. When I was in Chicago, I got to meet a couple of very top police. I said, how do you stop this? How do you stop this? If you were put in charge, do you think you could stop this? He said, Mr. Trump, I'd be able to stop it in 1 week. And I believed him 100%. Almost as shocking as the overwhelming crime rate in the city, is the fact that in 90% of these cases, where victims were either injured or killed, not a single suspect has been charged, Alan B. West reported. Perhaps this statistic came out at the end of Barack Obama's presidency, after allowing thugs to run free and excuse it is what disgruntled millennials do when suffering from poverty. What's interesting to note is that not a single one of these shootings this month involved a police officer, which is a big statistical change since Trump has been in office. Now, things could be getting a lot worse for these thugs and better for the city suffering under their wrath, since our president has vowed to combat the gangster and thug issue that runs rampant in inner cities across the country. He's one of the first to take a bold stance against it, proving he's not afraid of these criminals, and it's only a matter of time before he publicly addresses this issue again after his executive orders on the matter and sending ATF, alcohol, tobacco, and firearms agents in to help. Among his pile of important executive orders to get the country back on track, were three crucial ones targeting gangs, drugs, and crimes against cops. According to CNBC, the executive orders will focus on gang members, drug dealers, drug cartels, and crimes against law enforcement officers, Bustle reported. During Jeff Sessions' formal ceremony after his confirmation, President Trump announced his plans for these three executive orders, which give more authority to law enforcement. During his ceremony, Sessions said that the U.S. has a crime problem that may be a dangerous permanent trend, Bustle's reports added. In an effort to remedy this, Trump's latest executive orders will specifically target what he views as the leading causes of crime: gang members, drug cartels and dealers, and those who commit crimes against cops. If anyone is doing more for the Black community and proving Black Lives Matter than Barack Obama, it's his successor, President Trump. 88% of the victims in Chicago are Black and were all ignored while Obama was in office, pushing and supporting the Black Lives Matter movement. Trump will single-handedly save countless Black lives by cracking down on these thugs who kill other people, many of whom are random and just in the wrong place at the wrong time in the war zone.